Carpet tiles typically ship via FedEx Ground in manageable size boxes. The general tools recommended for installation is a T-square, sticky tabs if your tiles come with them, a knife, and double-sided carpet tape. Some tiles may have some loose fibers left over from shipping. You want to brush these off and clean up before getting started on the floor. The back of the tiles may have some loose fibers as well, so make sure to get these, along with locate the guide arrow. Many tiles have this type of arrow to help guide installation. The most popular methods of installation are monolithic, a straightforward pattern, quarter turn, alternating tiles, and ashlar brick, a straightforward yet alternating design. A custom floor, as seen here, can be made up of many types of patterns and designs. There are many pattern options and colors available, and it's a great way to add a personal touch to your space. These tiles have a sticky back and do not require any adhesive or tape. Some tiles have sticky tabs, which are designed to be an anchoring system and adhere to the bottom of the tiles, sticky side up, with two adhesive strips removed to adhere to the floor. You only use a quarter of the tab per each tile, as to adhere four tiles into place. Tiles that do not include sticky tabs or sticky backs can use double-sided carpet tape. For one strip of tape, you can adhere the corner of four tiles. When you come up to a wall or obstruction, take a measurement of the gap. It's best to mark on the bottom of the tile where it is you need to cut. I recommend using the boxes the tiles came in as a surface to cut them on. You want to start with a couple light grooves. Once you get a groove going, you can then press hard to try to get all the way through. Bend the tile to try to separate it. You may have some fibers holding on, which is okay. Sometimes it's best to use the surface for a final cut. Then put your cut tile right into place.